Dave and the Dominator are feeling the pressure to maximize every workable day, knowing they may not get back on the water for days or weeks on end. But the swell is throwing Dave around like a rag doll.
He'd be feeling that, that's for sure.
And on the surface, the Dominator is worried about his own safety and the boat.
Tell him to come up, I think.
Decide to head to a new spot, which they hope will offer more protection from the swell. With no abs on the boat, it's a disastrous start for Dave. Having left his sick wife, Misty, home alone, it's more stress he doesn't need.
My mind's just racing. It's not really where it needs to be at the moment because I've got so much else going on. Anxious all day, every day that I'm not at home now.
But I've got to keep the dollars ticking over as well. The bills don't stop.
Dave's an exceptional diver, and he loves it, and to be a good diver, you got to love it. He'd be battling the elements down there, he'd be getting tossed around everywhere, but he'd be going hard down there.
It's been really hard for me, emotionally. I need to hold it together, so I'm trying my best to do that. I feel like I've been out of it that long now, I'm just fingers off the pulse.
It's hard to sort of get in the groove and get my mojo back. I'm getting there, but it just takes time.
Think about it, diving, you never know what you're gonna get.
The new spot is more diver-friendly. Dave gets his first points on the board.
Bags up.
But as Dom inspects the hull, the size and quality of the abs is mixed.
Going good.
He's terrible.
The what is?
They're not good, are they?
They're not bad. They're pretty good.
That's what I thought. Nah, they look ugly. Oh. They look like a just colour.
That's pretty good. That'll be a 1-2. Don't be so hard on yourself, mate.
You've got high expectations.
I know you got high expectations, mate, but you just gotta, slow down a little bit. And you've had a call from Misty.
Yep. Is that a message or a...
Neil and Greg are diving a spot notorious for unpredictable breakers. A sheller, Neil, has to be on top of his game.
It's just the multitude of stuff that you have to get good at in this game. You know, to predict swell and tide and wind. You gotta learn when to call it quits. I guess sometimes it gets. And being a sheller, you're responsible for the boat. It's always a calculated risk. Greg's he's just really good at the deep. Hold his breath for 6 minutes without even thinking about it. I've been taught by the bloody elites in the game. I'm really lucky. And then Dad, once he knew that I was good enough, I worked the season that Peter got taken. That was my first year solo shelling.
Peter Clarkson was Neil's father's longtime Abalone dive partner. During Neil's first year shelling with Peter, Neil took a day off, and his father took his place on the boat. It was an ill-fated day at work. Peter never came home.
His dad said all of a sudden the compressor just went and started revving like, which means that something had been cut down below. And he looked around and he didn't say anything at first, and then he said he's seen the end of the hose hit the surface and just, like a hose does when you turn it on, which means it's been set. And then a matter of seconds later, he said Peter hit the surface. And he was in strife. The water was cloudy, and Dad said by the time he realised what was going on, all he was able to do was get him up to the side of the boat and try and get him in, but there's blood everywhere. The sharks that were there were already in a frenzy. Shark grabbed him, ripped him out of his hands, and
and that was the end of it. Bang, like that. That's all it takes. You know, Dad might weigh 85, 90 kilos, and you got, you know, 1,500 kilo shark coming up. You can't nothing.
Neil and Greg are diving a kilometer off the coast. It's a great spot for black lip abalone, but in today's swell, dangerous diving.
Weather like this just tests your patience, because it's like somebody sitting there poking with your stick. Like, that's what the swells are. Swell, 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 swell. And no, not only are you chipping abs off and having to find them or find the ground where the abs are, he has to get in there and, you know, try and get the abs out of all the cracks and crevices without getting destroyed by the shark cage. And they lay on their side and roll over and hit you in the head. And a wetsuit doesn't do much as a helmet.
Diving this reef also tests the boat handling skills of the sheller.
We've got a bit of a, like a piece of bottom sits up on this side, and then a piece of bottom sits up on this side, so we're sort of, we're right in the one spot where it's not going to break if it kicks. Snap one up on us. It gets you on edge working in areas like this. Sometimes these swells can be very, very sneaky. You know, you'll get a slow period come through and everything seems to settle down, and you just got to make sure you don't drop your guard. All divers have had an incident where something just catches you from behind and... Oh, check this out.
The constant swell has made diving here tough.
There's Gabe, popping it, eh?
With just 50 kilos of black lip abs on board, the pair make the call to continue the hunt elsewhere.